Hey, what's up? This is Paul Solt from Super Easy Apps. I'm going to take you on a tour. We're going to do a deep dive into what is auto layout. This is going to be a very beginner tutorial. I'm not going to cover everything, but I'm going to get you started on mimicking this UI that we see in front of us. All right, so this is Instagram. This is an older screenshot. A newer version of the screenshot that I have on my device is a little bit different, but I thought this one was a little bit more interesting than just a photo of myself. So here is a photo. We've got some buttons. We're going to learn how these are positioned on the screen. So we're going to create a UI that looks just like this. And I've gone ahead, I've created vector versions of all of these graphics. They're just quick, rough mockups, but I put them on separate artboards in Sketch, and I've exported them for us as PDFs or vectors. And then I also have a photo of my dog. We'll be using this. This is Ro. She is an Australian Shepherd. All right, so let's dive right in to Xcode. I've got an Xcode project set up right now. And what we're going to do is grab these graphics, and I'll include all the graphics that you can start with, and you can create your own Xcode project to follow along. Once we do that, we're going to drag them in. And the first step that we need to do is we need to make sure that we have everything selected here. And we're going to set these all to a single scale. We're going to do that for the vectors. And I'm going to do that also for this photo of Ro so that it's just going to be one image and we're not going to have any issues with it. All right, so those are our icons. They're all going to scale up and down because they're vector graphics. So we'll be great in our iPhone app. And then what we're going to do is we're going to jump into our storyboard file. So the first thing I'm going to probably start with is just setting the background color to some color. I'm going to go with this blue, and this is just going to give us a starting point to sort of see something, because a lot of the graphics that we have here are going to be white, and so they're going to be hard to see. So actually, Xcode's not really good at previewing those graphics because it's white on white. So that'll be interesting. But what we'll first need is a button. Now, if you don't see these images, you're going to need to quit Xcode to just go up to File, Quit, and open it up again. I just did this previously and I didn't see anything. So it's still like an intermittent bug where you will not see graphics in the, that's a multimedia editor. So we're going to be doing a lot of work with this right panel. So if you don't see this, make sure that it is open. We're going to switch over to the other view. This is going to show us our object library. Again, you're probably going to see this as a list view. You can switch this to this other view. We're looking for the button. We're going to drag one out and we're going to put it in the top left corner. Now, one of the other things that we're going to have to do is hide the status bar along the top. And so if we go ahead and run this for an iPhone 8, I've switched the simulator to iPhone 8, so it's a little bit smaller. We're going to see that the status bar is here. A real quick fix for that, I'm just going to uncomment, is this. You just need to override prefer status bar hidden and return true. And you can just start writing out prefer, and it should auto-complete for you, and or you can just type in what you see here. So leverage either of those, and if we do this, we run the app, it should hide that status bar. So we're going to need that out of the way so that we can have our buttons. Now I'll jump back over to our UI. We can't really see this button, but we need to add a graphic. And so this is going to be our close button, and we're going to see that now it has changed font. This is because it's now switched over to being a custom button. We're going to get rid of this text, and then I'm probably going to switch this back to system. That's going to change the color. I'm going to switch the, right now the tint color is set to a bluish color. We're going to switch this back to white, and that's going to make our button, it's a templated image, so it's going to make it, now this is going to need to resize. So one of the things that we can do is we can do command equals, and that should resize our button for us, but we're still going to have to replace where it goes. And that is under, there should be this size to fit content. That's what I did with this keyboard shortcut. So that is under editor. There's a bunch of options in editor to do stuff like this. So we've got alignment and arrangement that you can jump into. All right, so I'm just going to sort of mock out the UI as I sort of see fit. Let's pull that up and we'll put it on the left side of my screen so I can sort of see it. I'll zoom out a little bit and we're just gonna mock this up as we see it. So we've got two more buttons along the top. Just drag them and place them. And it's wanting to keep the space. It's wanting to do the 8 pixels or 8 points away. I can shift this over, and if I hold the Alt key, I can see how far away. So if I want them up against each other, I can do that, but it doesn't look like they're actually that close. So maybe I do want that spacing. So let's see what that looks like. That kind of looks like how it might be set up. Now we need to change the graphic here. I'm going to switch this over to our marker. And then we're going to get our, I think, text. All right, so something on the spacing isn't quite looking right, but that's okay. We just need something to give us sort of a rough idea of how this looks. Maybe we do need to go inset a little bit. This is something that you'll have to play with. For now, I'm just going to keep it so that it's in the top corners just to keep everything simple. And then you can go ahead and put it wherever you want. So we're going to have our save button down here. And this is going to be interesting because there's actually a label underneath this. And what I'm doing to create these duplicates is I'm holding the Alt or Option key and I'm clicking and dragging one of these UI elements. This last one is our story. And we have one more, which is going to be a different button. This is going to be a little bit different. This is our next arrow. And this has a background image. So we're going to switch this over to the white circle. And we're going to see that it looks like that. Now we have white on white because of the tint color. And so what I'll do is I'll just change the tint color to like this dark gray because they're using some kind of, it's not quite black. It's probably a little bit darker than the one that I've chosen, but that's probably a good start. Now, I'm looking at this and I'm thinking that we might need to move up a little bit to sort of match the UI. So I'm gonna put these in. Again, it's really up to you where you want these graphics. That's looking better to me. The top isn't looking quite right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull this in to the recommended bar. I've decided that I like how this is looking better. So we're just gonna pull that in and fix that up. It's not quite right. And so that's something that you'll have to dig around and sort of see what you like. But now what we can do is we can run this and we should see that our screen is starting to look like this. The next thing that we need to add onto the screen, the last big element is a image view. And that is this sort of tropical paradise here. So we're gonna go ahead and add that to our screen as well. But before I do that, why don't we just see what this looks like on just the iPhone 8? This is why we need auto layout. So what we've done is we've created the app so that it works great for the iPhone 8, but then it's not going to work great for the 8 Plus or the X, and that's where we're going to have to do some additional work. I'm just going to show you how to get it to work for the 8 Plus. So we're going to get it so that these icons are in the correct positions. And in order to do that, we're going to have to move things around a little bit. All right. And what I mean by that is we need to add some rules. And let's go ahead and add these rules before we add that background image, because this will be easier to add stuff to. So you can right click and drag to any of these areas and you get this sort of pop-up menu. We need to set up our top and our leading space for this graphic, and we add those constraints by clicking the Add Constraints button. Now, this should have an intrinsic content size, and this blue background is now making this really hard to see. I'm going to see if I can shift this. So it's just a faint background. We're going to see blue lines when things are good, and we're going to see red or orange if things are not good. Now, the problem that we're having on the 8 Plus is it's not taking into account the extra width here or the amount of space on the bottom. And also, one other thing I noticed is that this graphic is not correct. It's currently defaulting to the 40 by 40, but this is really a 60 by 60 image. So if I click on this, I can adjust the width manually, or I can do the command equals. The graphics should make that asset bounce up a little bit in size. So we'll just go ahead and do that. All right, so let's go, and I typically work top to bottom, outside in for the most part. It sort of depends on the relative positions of the elements. So we're gonna do the top space and the trailing space, the safe area. We'll add those two constraints for this graphic. Here we can set up the horizontal spacing. So that's gonna be a relative position. And we can either center this or we can just set it up to the top space as well. So that will anchor it in between the top and this element. And then let's go ahead and add our ones on the bottom. We're gonna do the trailing space and the bottom space, add those two constraints for that button. And we'll do the same thing for this corner. Again, I'm dragging diagonally so that I can get both the leading and then the bottom. If we drag in one direction, it does some context-sensitive stuff, and it's really not useful, in my opinion, because now we have no way to get to the bottom. So I always drag diagonally when I'm trying to add something for the most part, except for this one, since I just need a constraint between this one, and then I need a constraint to the bottom. All right, so if we run the app again on the iPhone 8 Plus, what we're gonna see is that our UI should be looking good. The next thing that we need to do is add some of the stuff. So we've got our buttons, you can click on any of them, and that's looking pretty good. The X, actually no, those are looking funky. What's going on up here? So we got some issue. I think this is because I'm hiding the status bar. If we comment this code out, I believe it's going to behave a little bit differently. So this is one of the situations that you have to take into account. I'm not necessarily going to fix this issue probably right now, but we can see that it's giving it that extra space right now. So because we're hiding it, it's not taking into account. And there's probably a fix in here that I can do. Probably because that status bar is away, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to set this up to 20 and we'll see how that looks. This should give us 20 is typically what we'd get for the standard value, but for whatever reason, when we add constant constraints ourselves, we can never seem to get that to be on gray. So we'll see if this looks any different. And there might be a fix on the view controller to... I'm going to set the top bar to none. I don't know if that would fix our issue. So now we might be down too far. We'll find out. Okay, so it's looking good over there. I don't have a quick fix right now for how to make this look better because there's probably another setting I'm missing somewhere. But don't worry about that just yet. We've got it working over here. And now the next step is to add that image. So I'm going to go ahead, drag an image onto our background. And we're going to resize it. Now I'm doing this way instead of, if I were to grab Rose image, it's huge. I don't know if you saw that, but you can see how big it gets. And that becomes a real pain to work with. So I'm not going to drag that onto the canvas because it's so large. And that's what you'd have if you're working with images. So we've got this down. Now you're going to notice that I can't, from here, if I right click and drag, I cannot add the constraints that I need. And so here we either need to use the document outline, which is this view over here. And if you don't see it, just click here and you should see it. You can drag directly from the image view up to view and we can get all of these in one go. Or you could drag from the view on the storyboard canvas over to the view and you could get all of these in one go. All right, so if I drag this up, I'm gonna hold the shift and select all four of these. And I'll add those constraints. Now, this is going to be something that you'll have to modify a little bit to work on the iPhone X. I'm not going to go into detail on that. We're just trying to get this to work for this situation. And then I'll go ahead and add a picture of Ro. So now that's there. Now, what we have to take into account is the layer order. The bottom layer, when we're looking at all of our views inside of our main view, is going to be the topmost. So what we have to do is we have to drag this all the way up to the top where it says safe area, and right underneath that we'll make it the background image. So if we go ahead and hit the run button, we now have a new UI that is mimicking the design aesthetics of the Instagram app. We've got all these buttons, so you can start to add some functionality and sort of make this app functional if you want to. You could also add some views here so that you could drag them around using a pan gesture. So these are some customizations that you can do. See if you can figure out how to do that. And I think it would be a great learning experience. All right, so that's a little rundown on starting from scratch, building the UI in Xcode using the UI designer, and then adding some auto layout constraints. Let me know if this video was helpful. If there's any questions that you have, just comment down below in the video. And if you like this, click the like button. I really appreciate it. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel to get updates when I have new videos. And as always, you can jump on over to the blog at supereasyapps.com to learn more about app development. I've got a new course coming out soon on getting started. It's called iPhone Apps 101. So that's on the horizon. That'll be published on YouTube, but I'll also have some extras and source code that you can get on my website. All right, so I hope this was helpful. Click the like button if this was useful, and I will have some more content related to auto layout later this month. So look forward to that.